Hello children, welcome back. Hope you all are fine. So we were discussing about your active and passive voice, right? So a sentence can be in the active voice form or it can be in the passive voice form, right? So already we have discussed about that one, and already you know that the active voice can be changed into passive voice and passive voice can be changed into active voice by changing the verb and your word the subject. Yes or no? Already we have discussed about the rules of the verbs and subjects when we are changing from active to passive, how it will change. So today we will do some of the questions based on the same topic. So let's go for the exercise. So here you can see. So let's start the exercise. The first one is your what? Check the voice of the sentences. That means what? Some sentences are given. You have to write whether the sentence is in the active voice or this is in the passive voice. Okay? Place is not there. That's why I'm writing active voice as AV. A for active, V for voice. And passive voice as PV. That is passive voice. Okay? So that's why what? Check the voice of the sentence. That means you have to check that whether the sentence is in the active voice or that is in your passive voice. Okay? And you have to write. Some blanks are also given. So after the sentence, you have to write AV if that is in the active voice. If that is in the passive voice, you have to write PV. Okay? So let's start. The first sentence is your what? Sheila plays the piano. Sheila plays the piano. Always remember that before you are moving to the question, first you have to find out what the verb and subject. Why? Because voice is nothing but the relation. It shows the relation between what? The subject and your verb, right? So first you have to find out the verb and your word subject. Then you can determine whether the sentence is in active form or in the passive form, okay? So Sheila plays the piano. Here what? The directly the subject Sheila. Sheila is the subject. Plays is what? This is the in the VS form. And this is in the what? In the present tense, right? So plays the piano, directly Sheila is doing something or she does something, right? Sheila plays the piano. So directly does something. So that's why here what? This is in the, yes, this is in the active voice, right? So that's why Sheila plays the piano is in the which voice? Yes, this is in active voice, okay? So here I am writing AV. AV, that means active voice. Okay, now moving to the second one, you can see B is what? The ball is kicked by the boy. The ball is kicked by the boy. So here you can see that, yes, the subject is what? The boy. The boy is the subject. Who has done the action? Yes, the boy has done the action. So the boy is the subject here. And the verb is what? The verb is kicked. So kick is what? This is the V3 form of the verb V, what? Kick. So here we can see that the verb is in the what? Yes, the verb is in the V3, that is the past participle form. And the boy, by the boy. That means here what? The action is received by the subject. So here, because by the boy is used and the verb is in the V3 form, that is the past participle form, here we can say that, yes, the sentence is in what? This is in the passive voice, right? So here I am writing PV. So PV is what? That is the passive voice. Okay? Moving to the third one. Rohit sings a song. Rohit sings a song. So here you can see directly the subject has done something. So Rohit sings a song. So because this is direct, Rohit is the subject. And sings. Sings means what? This is in the VS form of the sing, right? So here sings a song. So this is in the active voice, right? So A, V. So always remember that before finding out whether this is in the active voice or passive voice, first you have to find out the verb and the subject. Then you move to the question, whatever it is given. Okay? Now moving to the next one. What? Moving to the next one, that is what? A pilot flies aeroplanes. So here, which one is the subject? Yes, that is a pilot is your subject. So what is the action? Yes, that is your verb is flies. A pilot flies aeroplanes. This is in which voice? Yes, this is in the active voice. Why? Because directly the subject is has done something or it does something. Right? So here because directly the subject is doing, so that's why this is in the active voice. And you can see that the verb is in the VS form. Right? So here VS form, so that's why this is what? This is in the active voice. AV I have written. Okay? Moving to the last bit, what is that? The crops were sown by the farmers. The crops were sown. So here what the sown, S-O-W and sown is what? This is the V3 form of sow. You know sow, right? Putting seeds in the soil is called as S-O-W, sow. Okay? So sown, S-O-W and sown is what? This is the V3 past participle form of the verb S-O-W, sow. Okay? So the crops were sown by the farmer. So the farmer is the subject. So here the farmer receives the action. Right? So that's why this is in what? The passive voice. Right? So here we have to write this is in the passive voice. Hope you understood about this one. Next, moving to the next question. What is the question? Change the sentences from active voice to passive voice. Okay? Some sentences are given and that are in active voice. We have to change that into passive voice. Okay? So, I think you all remember the rules. How the verbs and the subjects change when we are changing active voice into passive voice. Okay? So, let's start the exercise. So, see the first question. What is the question? So, we sing songs. So, we sing songs. So, here you can see we is the subject, sing is the verb. Okay? And as you know, this is in the present tense. So, already you know in present tense, if the verb is in the present tense, then how to change that into passive voice? What is the rule? Yes, we have to what? The passive voice will be what? One be verb will be used. Okay? If that is singular, you have to use is. If that is plural, you have to use are. Along with the V3 form of the verb, that is past participle form of the verb. Right? So let's see what will be the sentence in passive voice. So we sing songs, it will become what? The songs are sung by us. As you know, we will change from we to us while changing active to passive. And the V3 form of sing is what? Sung. And songs. Here plural. So that's why we have to use are. So the songs. Yes. The songs are sung by us. First. Okay. We sing songs will become the songs are sung by us. So, we will become us, sing will become our sung. Okay? Now, moving to the next one, what is that? Bob reads a book. Bob reads a book. Again, this sentence is also in the present tense. Why? Because the verb reads is what? This is the VS form, that is in the present tense. VS. Bob reads a book. So, here Bob is the subject. And as you know that while changing from active to passive, if any of the names are there, Bob, okay, Ram, Rahim, if any of the names are there, then while changing from active to passive, what happens? The particular names will remain as it is, right? So here, Bob reads a book. So after converting into passive form, what it will look like? Yes. So Bob reads a book will what? The book is read by Bob. So, here only one book. So, that's why is. If books are. Okay? So, let's write the sentence. So, the book is read. R-E-A-D, read. By Bob. So, here you can see read. Okay? Reads read. as you know, the for the verb read, read, right? The V2 and V3 form are same. Read only. Read. Right? So here the book is read by Bob. Bob will remain as it is. Okay? Now moving to the next one. Ali teased the dog. Ali teased the dog. Here you can see that teased the dog. That means what? The sentence is in the past tense. Okay? So because this is in the past tense, what we have to use was or were. So here only one dog. Ali teased how many dogs? Only one dog. So here you have to use was. So the dog was teased by Ali. Okay? So now the dog was teased by Ali. Okay? So the Ali teased the dog because this is in the past tense. So, and what teased is what? Teased is the V2 form of tease. Tease, teased. Okay? Tease, teases, tease, teased. Teasing, to tease. So these are the six forms of the verb tease, right? So V2 and V3. And already you know that some regular verbs have both V2 and V3 same. Okay? Taste, teased. V2 and V3 both are same. So here, was will be used. Why? Because this was in the past tense. But in the previous A and B word, these were in the present tense. So that's why we have used is or are according to the object. If that is singular, you have to use is. If that is plural, you have to use are. Because this is in the past tense, singular. One dog, right? So that's why we are using here was. Okay? Now moving to some more questions. So, moving to some more questions, let's see what are they. The first one is, she will post the letter. Okay? So, can you tell me this is in which tense? Yes, this is in the future. Why? Because will is used here, right? So, what are the rules when the sentence is in the future and in active voice? Yes, you have to change will into will be along with the V3 form of the verb, right? So, let's see what is the sentence. So, here you can see, she will post the letter. She is the subject here. Will post. Okay, post. Post is what? That is the verb here. The letter. The letter is your object here. So, why changing this into your what? So, she will post the letter will become what? The letter will be posted by her. Yes or no? The letter will be posted by her. Why? Because already we know that she will become her and he will become him. If he is there, he will post the letter will become what? The letter will be posted by him. So he will become him, she will become her. Why changing from active to passive? And will post will become will be posted. So let's write the sentence. So the letter will be posted by her. Posted by her. Okay? Now moving to the last one, that is snow covered the mountains. Snow. You know snow, right? Snow covered the mountains. So here, snow covered the mountains. What? So here, snow is the subject. So actually, it is not doing any action, but here we have to take like that. Now, covered the mountains. Covered is the action here. Right? So snow covered the mountain. This is mountains. Mountains is what? This is in the plural form. And covered is what? This is in the past. Right? So the sentence is in the what? In the past tense. So here, while changing this into passive voice, snow will remain as it is. Mountains is there. So that's why we have to use where. Past tense is here. That's why we have to use not was or where. But because mountains is what? That is plural. So we have to use where. So the sentence will become what? The mountains were covered by snow. Yes or no? So the mountains were covered. So covered, the V2 and V3 form both are same for cover. Okay, covered, covered. So here the same thing, were covered by snow. Okay, so hope you understood about this one. This is very important. If you did not got this one, you have to once again watch the rules of the verbs and your subject. What are the rules when we are changing from active to passive? Okay, if you are clear about that, you can change any of the active sentences into your passive form. Okay, now moving to some complex sentences. If you have some have, has, had, then how to change that into passive voice? In the next video, we will discuss about that. Okay.